Good morning. Today we are going to compare linear and rotational values as a part of our review of the AP Physics C Mechanics curriculum.
Flippin' physics!
Billy, what are the linear and rotational equations for displacement?
Well, displacement is change in position, which equals position final minus position initial. For linear position, the symbol is sometimes x, it could be y, z, or sometimes r. For angular position, the symbol is theta. Displacement is a vector.
Bobby, how about the equations for average and instantaneous velocity?
Average velocity equals change in position over change in time, and instantaneous velocity equals the derivative of position with respect to time. Velocity is a vector. We use the symbols for linear and angular position Billy just identified. And the symbol for angular velocity is a lowercase omega, which looks like a curly W.
Bo, please give me the equations for average and instantaneous acceleration.
It is almost exactly what Bobby just said, only replace position with velocity. Acceleration is a vector, and the symbol for angular acceleration is alpha. However, some people like to call it
fishy thing.
Now let's talk about the uniformly accelerated motion, or UAM, equations. I've written out the four UAM equations in a form that's not quite the same as what's written on your AP equation sheet. For example, the first equation is velocity final equals velocity initial plus acceleration times time, where that time is defined as time final when time initial is equal to zero. I find this form just a little bit easier to work with than what's on your AP equation sheet. Okay, now let's move on to talking about the uniformly angularly accelerated motion, or U fishy M, equations.
U fishy M!
The angular U fishy M equations follow the same form as the linear UAM equations. For example, the second U fishy M equation is angular position final equals angular position initial plus angular velocity initial times time plus 1/2 times the angular acceleration times time squared. Billy, what is the linear equation for mass?
What?
There is no linear equation for mass.
Oh, right. Okay.
Exactly. Now, Billy, what is the rotational equation for mass?
Rotational mass is called moment of inertia. The symbol for moment of inertia is capital I, and there are two equations. The moment of inertia of a system of particles is the sum of the mass of each particle times r squared, or the square of the distance each particle is from the axis of rotation. And the moment of inertia for a rigid object with shape is the integral of r squared with respect to mass.
Bobby, please give us the equations for linear and rotational kinetic energy.
Linear or translational kinetic energy equals 1/2 mass times velocity squared, and rotational kinetic energy equals 1/2 mass times velocity squared, only the mass is rotational mass or moment of inertia, and the velocity is angular velocity.
Billy, how about Newton's second law?
Net force equals mass times acceleration, where force and acceleration are vectors. There is also net force equals the derivative of momentum with respect to time, where momentum is a vector. Then there is the rotational form of Newton's second law. Net torque equals moment of inertia times angular acceleration, and net torque also equals the derivative of angular momentum with respect to time. And torque, fishy thing, and angular momentum are all vectors.
Bo, please give us the equations for force and torque.
The equation for force...
There is no general equation for force. There are only equations for net force, which I just talked about.
Right. There are equations for some forces, like the force of gravity and the force of friction. However, there's no general equation for a single force.
The equation for torque is torque equals the cross product of R and F. The symbol for torque is the lowercase Greek letter tau. R is the position vector from the axis of rotation to the location of the force. And torque R and F are all vectors. And yes, the order matters because the cross product is not commutative. So it has to be R cross F in that order.
Bobby, the equations for power, please.
Linear or translational power is the derivative of work with respect to time, which also equals the dot product of force and velocity, where both force and velocity are vectors. I guess the equation is initially the same for rotational power. Rotational power equals the derivative of work with respect to time, only now it's the dot product of torque and angular velocity, where torque and angular velocity are vectors.
And lastly, Billy, please tell us about momentum.
Linear momentum, the symbol for which is a lowercase p, not an uppercase p, which is for power. So linear momentum equals mass times velocity, where momentum and velocity are vectors. There are two equations for angular momentum, the symbol for which is an uppercase L. The angular momentum of a particle equals r cross p, where r is the distance from the center of mass of the particle to the axis of rotation, and p is the momentum. And the angular momentum of a rigid object with shape equals the object's moment of inertia times the object's angular velocity. Oh, and angular momentum, r momentum, and angular velocity are all vectors.
Thank you, everybody. That completes our review of linear and rotational values as a part of the AP Physics C Mechanics curriculum. Next, feel free to enjoy my Universal Gravitation review or visit my AP Physics C review webpage. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.